in our new video of class 7th SST and history portion, and today we are taking our chapter 7, which is towns, traders and craft persons. Students, in that we were on topic traders and craft persons on page number 81. So students, in your course book page number 81, traders and craft persons. Different communities dominated trade in various parts of the country. In the north, Multani and Punjabi merchants handled it. So, if you make a small map of India, so, you know, if we make a map of India like this, so we see that in, you know, North India, Multan, which is in Pakistan now, and Punjab is in both sides in India and Pakistan. So in North India, there were two major business groups, Multani businessmen and Punjabi businessmen. And the Bhats handled trade in Gujarat, and the Bhats handled trade and business in Gujarat and Rajasthan. And Khorasans, foreign traders from Central Asia. So, it's from Central Asia, some foreign traders are there, named Khorasans, and they were engaged in all over India to do their business. Indian handicrafts have been popular for their artistic and functional value since ancient times. Other crafts were influenced by Persian and indigenous painting traditions and gained popularity. So, Indian handicrafts, Bharati Hastakala, had been popular for their aesthetic and functional value since ancient times. So all the handworks, handicrafts of India, that would be weaving of clothes, that would be, you know, any small scale industries of handicrafts. So these all works of Indian handicrafts were very popular at that time because of their aesthetic and functional value, because they were aesthetic and fibers which were made from Indian handicrafts and, you know, functions. And you know, the performance of that products and the quality of that products was very popular in, from ancient times or since ancient times. And two types of you know, handicrafts were there in your country. In there it was Persian craft work and there was Indian craft work. So people used to learn these two you know, handicrafts work, and they used to gain popularity because of these two works, Persian handicrafts and crafts or Indian crafts. So Persian, which is Iranian crafts and handicrafts, was famous in India, and Indian crafts was also having their aesthetic and functional value. And then we see the Salia weavers from Thanjavur and Uraipur were producers of fine quality clothes, and these two areas of you know, Thanjavur and Uraipur were very famous. The Salia weavers, and they produce fine quality clothes, and they produce clothes for temple festivals, kings and nobility, and coarse cotton clothes for the masses. So they used to make you know, clothes for temple festivals, kings and nobility, you know, ministers, and coarse cotton clothes for the masses, and some, you know, cotton clothes for masses. So famous trading towns. The trading towns were settlements where majority of the people used to be engaged in activities associated with trade. This town developed around manufacturing centers. Let us study about them in detail. Some famous trading towns were emerged and developed in the time. And in them we see Hampi, which is located in Karnataka, was very important trading towns. Hampi is located in Karnataka on the banks of river Tungabhadra. It was the capital of Vijayanagara Empire. So in past time Hampi was capital of Vijayanagara Empire, which is located in Karnataka, founded by Harihar and Bukhara. The remains of Hampi show that the city was a well fortified one. City was very well fortified, the forts of city and the buildings of city are well maintained, and that is why trade works were there in that city, in that trading town. It was a center of important commercial and cultural activities. The architecture of Hampi was magnificent. So the architecture work of Hampi, and it was a center of important commercial and cultural activities. And the Muslim merchants, Moors and Chetis and Portuguese and European trading agents came to Hampi markets. And market was very huge, and that is why it was a trading town. So Muslim merchants like Moors and Chetis and Portuguese and European trading agents came to the Hampi for their business. And the temples were the main centers of cultural activities. As we know, temples were the main center of cultural activities. And Hampi was popular as a center of textile industry. And there was center of textile industry in Hampi that was famous in cotton, cloth industry. And in mining, metal work and agricultural production was where other features of this town. Mining, metals and coal. So this was also, and agriculture production was also a feature of this town. Virupaksha temple in Hampi is a tourist attraction. It has a 50-meter high gopuram, large pyramidal tower over the entrance gate of temple. The 50-meter high tower, the entrance gate of that temple, Virupaksha, which is very famous, which is very tourist, very famous tourist place in Hampi and Karnataka. And Hampi fell into ruins with the defeat of Vijayanagara Empire in 1565 by the rulers of Delhi Sultanate. And in 1565, the rulers of Delhi Sultanate ruined Hampi town in 1565. And from there, Vijayanagara Empire defeated by rulers of Delhi Sultanate. Then it was ruined, it was destroyed. And now students, page number 82, I get to know Colonel Colin Mackenzie, the first Surveyor General of India, was the first person to survey the ruins of Hampi in 1800. So, Colonel Colin Mackenzie, the first Surveyor General of India, was the person to survey the ruins of Hampi. Hampi mein tabahi machi thi, nuksan hua tha, uske survey ke liye Colonel Colin Mackenzie आगे आए, जो कि फर्स्ट सर्वेयर जनरल ऑफ इंडिया बने. एंड इन एक्टिविटी यू टू कलेक्ट पिक्चर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट बाम्बू क्राफ्ट वर्क्स इन इंडिया इन एक कॉलेज. सो व्हाट आर द सम बाम्बू मनी मास के कितने हैंडीक्राफ्ट से क्राफ्ट वर्क होते हैं, उसको आपको लिस्ट बनाना है. देन स्टूडेंट्स, वी सी मछलीपट्टनम. द टाउन ऑफ मछलीपट्टनम और मछलीपट्टनम वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड ऑन द डेल्टा ऑफ रिवर कृष्णा. द अरब ट्रेडर्स मेड मछलीपट्टनम ए पोर्ट टाउन इन द 14th सेंचुरी. It became a famous port on the Andhra coast. So, on the coast of Andhra Pradesh, sea coast of Andhra Pradesh, is Mashilipatnam town is established on the nearby delta of river Krishna. The Arab traders made Mashilipatnam a port town in the 14th century. And Arab traders used to come from the seaway, the sea route, and they used to come to the coast of Andhra Pradesh and used to start their business from Mashilipatnam. During the Satavahana rule, it was also a seaport for the east coast of India. And there was a seaport, there was a Bandargah, which was a seaport on the coast of Andhra Pradesh in Satavahana rule in 14th century. And this town is still popular for its Kalamakari work. So this town is doing some handicrafts and crafts, Kalamakari work. Then handworks, and a kalam or a pen made of bamboo, and then in that a pen is made by bamboo bars, is used to pen wood material with natural dyes, and by that pen they used to paint some materials with dyes, and dynasty of Persia was the major importer of Kalamkari textiles. And you know, textiles and clothes was very imported from Safavi dynasty of Persia. So there were relations between India and Persia at that time, and we used to import Kalamkari textiles and their clothes. Then we used to do handicrafts and craft on that. Okay students, today we covered traders and craft persons, famous trading towns. In that we have concluding Hampi, which is in Karnataka, and Vasilipatnam, which is in the coast of Andhra Pradesh, western coast of India. So very important. And in next video students, we will see about Surat, which is located in Gujarat, which is also a trading town. This will be discussed in next video. Okay students, till then, have a nice day. Thank you.